story right now is not great. We are definitely not the most attractive place to do business in Africa. And like Kai said, if you look at the Ernst & Young's Africa Attractiveness Report, we are number 4 on the list. But if you look at the practical aspects of the market, we see them put together. Ghana is not even, we don't even appear on the radar. In fact, the 10 best places to do business in the world today are quite African countries. Guess it's surprising there in that market. Benin. So Benin has aggressively gone to this stage of reforms to make sure they are attractive. Unfortunately, it's a very small economy with not as much resources as Ghana has. So unfortunately, they do not have the attraction that Ghana has. But just a little of the statistics. From the World Bank's Ease of Doing Business 2017, on the total composite, we are 108 out of 190 countries. That is not a comfortable lead. It's not even a comfortable position at all. And we think that we have a right of place among the rest, so we should be there. And it's also a question of national pride. But beyond that, it's also a question of your economy. How you are going to grow your economy, and like that, I'm sure those of you are politically inclined. I'm sure you kept hearing jobs. You know, the only way you can increase the number of jobs, create more businesses, invest more, create more opportunities for more jobs to get it. So that number 108 is really bad. And we dropped between 2016 and 2017, we actually dropped 7 points. So something must have gone wrong. We need to rectify that. Trade across borders, we're 154. Out of 190. I'm not sure that's the position we want to be. Getting credit, we're a little better. We are number 44 out of 190. We think we should do a lot more better than that. And enforcing contracts, which is probably one of our biggest challenges, we are 114 out of 190. Now, in investment promotion facilitation, prior to this period, we've been almost passive investor promoters, both domestic and international. And that's why I said a lot of domestic people, indigenous investors, think that GIP is for only foreigners. Because they have to register the company. Because our indigenous businesses don't have to register, they don't come here at all. In fact, they don't seem to have anything to do with us. And so GIPC was almost passive. But now, like I said, we will look for you, we'll come to you, we'll engage you, and where do you? There are possibilities of incentives to present to you such that we can have a very vibrant business rather. Ultimately, and I know when I say this, I'm going to be once again attacked with the press. What we want to create is a great business environment, whether you're a foreigner or you're a Ghanaian. You must have a great business environment where you can make your money, spend it how you want, and do the things you want legally.
The end result of all these reforms and all the plans that we're doing is to reposition Ghana as the entry point into West Africa. So we are looking at creating Ghana, recreating Ghana to be the business hub in West Africa that will do manufacturing, value-added processing. It will be the financial hub of West Africa because we're going to create the International Financial Services Center in Ghana and attract more financial institutions and have more access to money. So that we can and try and bring down the cost of money so a private sector can borrow to do the things it ought to do.